Welcome to Furniture Clinic. In this video, we're going to show you how to repair a small scuff or scratch on leather. The front of this car seat has quite a severe scuff caused by a sharp object scraping along the surface, but with a little time and effort, this damage can be repaired to look like new. To do this, we'll be using a leather touch-up kit. The touch-up kit is available in various shades to match different colours of leather, or it can be ordered in a specific colour to match your leather exactly. Each kit comes with full instructions telling you how to repair and colour match leather. The first part of the kit is the alcohol cleaner, which is used to wipe the leather down before applying colour. You always start your colour match with the base colour, which in this case is black. The base is tinted using three tints to help it blend in better, and if you go too dark, there is a larger bottle of white that is used to lighten the colour. A small mixing cup and stirrer are also supplied to mix the colours together with, and you also get a sponge to apply the colour onto the leather. The kit is then finished off with two lacquers in matte and gloss, which are used to seal the colour in. The first step is to wipe the leather down with the alcohol cleaner. This is a simple process and is done to make sure the colour adheres properly to the leather when applied. Simply pour a small amount of alcohol cleaner onto a cloth and wipe the surface of the leather to remove any contaminants. This scuff is quite rough, so we're going to sand it first using 1200 grit sandpaper to make it smooth. Leather is really tough and can be sanded a lot, so don't be scared to apply pressure to get good results. As you sand the leather, keep wiping the surface with your finger to test how smooth it is getting, and then stop when you're happy. Take your time when sanding the leather, as the more time you put into the preparation, the better the end results will be. We also have a range of fillers for leather if the scuff you are repairing is heavily damaged. The next step is to apply the colour onto the leather. Since this leather is black, we're just going to apply the black base colour straight onto the scuff. But if the leather was another colour, we'd most likely need to tint it first. You can watch our other videos to show you how to tint and colour match leather. Shake the bottle well and apply the colour onto a sponge. Wipe away any excess colour back into the bottle and dab the scuff with the sponge. If you apply too much, dab it off using a clean part of the sponge. The colour can then be left for about 10 minutes to dry, or dried off instantly with a hairdryer. If the damage is still visible after one application, apply a second coat in the exact same way. The colour will always dry shiny, but this will be altered later when we apply the finish. Although the scratch could be further improved by applying more colour, for speed and to get better results, we'll fill the damage first using the heavy filler. This is a flexible filler used for fixing scuffs, scratches and holes in leather. Using a spatula, spread the heavy filler over the scuff and then wipe any excess away. This could then be left to dry naturally for about 10 minutes or dried instantly with a hairdryer. If the damage still feels rough after one application, a second can be applied and dried off in the exact same way. Always sand the heavy filler in between coats using 1200 grit sandpaper for a perfectly smooth finish. When the scuff is filled level, finish it off with another sand to make the repair nice and smooth, and then apply another coat of colour. Using the sponge, dab the colour onto the leather to cover the white mark left by the filler. Don't wipe the colour on, as this can create streak marks. Instead, always dab the colour because this will create a finish in keeping with the natural grain pattern of the leather. Dry the colour off with a hairdryer or allow it to dry naturally. A second coat of colour is then applied to blend the repair in better with the leather and dried off with a hairdryer in the exact same way as before. The repair is only now slightly standing out because it has a shiny surface compared to the rest of the leather. We'll rectify this by sponging the finish onto the leather to dull the shine of the colour. The kit comes with a matte finish for dull leather and the gloss finish for shiny leather. However, this leather has a slight shine to it, which we call satin. To achieve this, simply mix the matte and the gloss together, shaking them both very well before doing so. Normally you would mix the two finishes 50-50 for satin, but this leather is slightly duller, so we'll be adding a little more matte. There is no right or wrong way to mix this, you just need to experiment until you get it spot on. Pour the two finishes into the mixing cup and stir thoroughly to mix them together. Using a sponge, dab the finish onto the repaired area so it becomes slightly wet and shiny. Then, in the same way as before, dry the finish off with a hairdryer or leave it to dry naturally for 10 minutes. As the finish dries, you can see it taking the shine away from the area, helping it blend in perfectly with the surrounding leather. A second coat is then applied in the same way as the first. This is because the finish not only helps to blend the colour in better, but it also makes the repaired area more scuff, scratch and stain resistant, so you can be confident knowing you have a long lasting repair. You can now see as we finish this job that the repair has completely blended in with the surrounding leather.